Hello everyone, welcome to the Nocturnal Studio dev stream. This is our first stream that we are going to be having, so I am happy to have you all here on this journey. We are an indie game development studio, so we're just getting started. Today I just want to go over who we are, talk about our new game that came out, Quarantine Arena, and all the exciting stuff that we've been up to recently.
So first of all, I'm Lily. I'm the marketing director for Nocturnal Studios, and this is
Crystalline. I'm the studio director, and I did some of the art for Quarantine Arena.
Okay. We also have two of our other developers on voice chat.
Hello, I'm Andrew Pyle. I did the coding and the lead design for Quarantine Arena.
I'm Cameron Ingalls, and I help do the art.
Awesome. Okay. So I think one of the biggest things is that this project was like a kickoff for Nocturnal Studios, and it had kind of an interesting beginning. Can you tell us about it?
Yeah. So Nocturnal Studios actually came together pretty quickly and probably as a surprise to most of us. So we were attending the QuakeCon at home this year. And during the first day of the event, we saw that there was a posting for the version alpha game jam. And, you know, it already a day had passed, and it was, can you make a game within those just 2 days? We're like, I don't know if we have the time to do it, but, you know, let's take a shot. So after debating it for a while, we decided to go straight into making a game. And I believe it was that Saturday afternoon, so it was the second day. We're like, okay, let's get started. We have 20 hours until we have to submit the game. And just kind of took off from that point. So we worked for 20 hours straight and made Quarantine Arena. And
the rest is history.
We had a really fun experience putting it together, and I think by the time that we had, you know, worked on it for the 20 hours nonstop, just trying really hard to get something from start to end, we realized how fun it was and wanted to keep doing it. Mm-hmm. So whenever we submitted it to the judges and all the community was, you know, playing all the games that everyone made, we're like, yeah, maybe we want to actually keep doing this, not make this like a one-time thing. During the actual development of it, we had made like more sprites or more things to put in the game. We had different ideas for like more monsters, more items that we just didn't have time to implement during the 20 hours because it takes time to put it all together and put it in the code. And, we decided to just go ahead and for the next week try to put it all together and make a more finished version of the game.
Mm-hmm.
And I think during that is when we realized that we could keep doing this as a team, right, and actually make Nocturnal Studios come to life.
I think most of us on the group or team have always had somewhat of a passion just to, you know, try to make games and go out there, put yourself out there and make a product. But
yeah,
it's not very often you get an opportunity like that. So it was great that QuakeCon held that game jam so we could get started and get the ball rolling. And now we're here.
Definitely. It gave us a lot of motivation to actually make a project come to life and make us want to keep doing it, even though we've always kind of done small things here and there.
You guys always had a project going on, but the game jam gave you that incentive to actually complete it.
Yes,
in
definitely.
A very finite time period.
Yeah,
20 hours.
it very much it forced us to kind of control our scope, kind of hone in our ambitions, and make sure that we put something out that's practical to finish within that time span.
Right, and you did have a good team. You had Cameron was doing art, mm-hmm. Crystal was doing art, Andrew, you were doing coding. With the three of you versus most of the other teams had one person, so
yeah,
that was nice. Having more people, but you also, while they all had good projects, mm-hmm. you were the only one that actually had from start to finish a game. So that was pretty cool.
Yeah. I think it definitely helped that we had a full team that was able to work together, put time in and put it together. But it was pretty amazing seeing what, you know, everyone did during the competition and giving us that kind of kickstart to, you know, complete it.
How was your experience, Cameron?
Very grueling. We stayed up all night and just worked.
Yeah, I think that's another advantage we kind of pulled over the others is that we just didn't really stop. We just kept going. And I can't blame any of the other developers for not, you know, living the whole
night. The one that did the BYOC, they stayed up all night too.
I believe it. Yeah, that was great. I mean,
you did a lot.
I think many of the other projects, whether you could consider them finished or full games or whatnot, they were still like really great art pieces that capture the ambience of QuakeCon. And those are great to see.
All right. So, let's see. You had Tim Willett's voice.
Oh, yeah.
Yes, he graciously offered to do the voice acting.
Did he offer or did you ask?
Okay, well, requested, but I mean agreed to do the voice acting for Doom Guy in Quarantine Arena. That was great that he was able to lend his time to help us with that on such a very short notice, considering we didn't even know we were going to do the game jam.
Yeah.
So the same day, him going, I'll record some lines.
We would stop and bring them downstairs from their computer and make them eat. And as we're eating, we always have like conversations over our dinner. Mm-hmm. And the kids are just, they couldn't stop talking about the game. They're just, we need this, we have to do this, we have to do this. And so then we started bouncing ideas and somehow Tim Willits got brought up.
I don't know how, but it did. And so it was
the rest is history.
Last minute addition that I think
that was good though.
Helps the community.
It was fun because Tim is part of QuakeCon. It always will be, even though he moved on from id.
It's been every QuakeCon, right? He's kind of
Every QuakeCon, and he was at this one too.
Yeah,
and he played with people and all kinds of things. Mm-hmm. So, how were you judged in the game jam?
It was sorted by two categories. One was an overall feeling of like how put together the game was for being in that short period of time. And then the second was if it related to the theme of the game, which was there's no place like home. So I think we scored a 4.8 out of 5 in both the categories.
Nice.
And that's how we ended up securing first place for the contest.
Cool. All right, so I think we're going to go ahead and load into the game and have Andrew playing while we go over like what gameplay is like for the game, the different monsters, what you've added, what you had in the beginning, because you didn't just leave this at the game jam release. You've done more since then.
Yeah, we added a whole lot of stuff to the game, so I think we can go over that whenever we load it up and take a look.
So basically, you took the week after QuakeCon to add in some of the artwork that you'd made before, flesh out some of those ideas, and make the game last a little bit longer.
Yes.
And Andrew could not hold back making it more difficult.
Oh, of course not.
Unfortunately.
I promise it's possible. It's possible.
Which does lead us to one point before we get into the game. We have a contest.
Yeah, so for the contest, it's basically challenging all of our players if they can beat the game on ultraviolence for one portion. So the first four players that beat the game and show the end screen that they made it all the way through all the waves will win an exclusive Quarantine Arena t-shirt.
So you play the game on ultraviolence, you make it all the way through all 10 waves, you beat the special thing at the end, and you get the Doom Guy's computer screen, end screen that is special to that difficulty.
Mm-hmm.
And you capture that like with a print screen, or if you're Twitch streaming, whatever it is, you have to capture that screen. And then you put it in our Discord, and that is an entry to the contest.
Absolutely.
All right. So the first four to do that will receive one of these t-shirts.
Yeah.
Cool.
And then we also do have another portion of the contest. Thankfully, we are sponsored by Balls, and they graciously offered to help supply and some of the prizes for this contest. This is if you beat the game on Nightmare mode. So the first player to win the game on Nightmare, they also receive an exclusive Quarantine Arena shirt. This one is different from the Ultraviolet's one. And they also win a case of balls and some ball swag.
Now, Andrew, can you tell us about Nightmare mode?
Well, there's not much more to say about it other than the fact that if you get hit by anything in the game, one stray projectile, if you get touched by one of the enemies, one hit, no matter what it is, and that's game over. So it's much more difficult than the other difficulties, because even in Ultraviolence, where at the start it'll probably take around two hits to die, you can upgrade your health and whatnot, but in Nightmare, no matter what upgrades you get, it's always one hit, one kill.
All right. That's hard.
Yes, but the first player who manages to beat it.
Now, this shirt, it has the Inferno COVID demon, and it is the only one in existence ever.
Correct.
So to get that red kind of Catco demon-esque look with Quarantine Arena, you have to actually beat it on Nightmare. That sounds, pretty fitting.
Absolutely.
Not to mention the case of balls and ball swag, of course.
Oh, yeah.
Which is a big motivator. Like, every time I've posted this somewhere, everyone's like, I'm going to win some balls. And then they're like, I can't get past wave four.
with practice, someone will get it.
So eventually.
Hopefully.
Maybe in 10 years.
Yeah. Well, the contest does have an end date.
Yes, this contest will end on September 24th, so we have about a month and a day, and then the contest will come to a close.
So we really hope someone's going to win this. If we can't get someone on Nightmare, we'll end up giving it to the first person to get on Ultraviolet.
Oh, that makes sense, yeah.
Because we want to give someone some balls.
Absolutely.
Because, to do this, you had to have some balls.
Yeah.
Andrew, are you ready?
Yeah, I'm ready.
All right.
I'm ready.
I don't see it. No. So this worked in our test stream.
That'd be too easy.
Yay, balls joke. Thanks for sticking around, Uplink. All right. Is it not going to work?
Hold up. I might be able to get it.
All right, because if you can't, I do have a backup to do it on my computer. You'll just have to play with my keyboard and mouse. You're going to uplink. I want to see you in the shirt. Please do. I won't be able to tell.
Yes, it's on, yeah.
Okay, thank you.
Great. Alright, I guess we can get started on... Probably just going to start out with Ultraviolence.
Ooh! Alright, so can you beat Ultraviolence? Because I want to kind of show off all of the game.
To start off, I think we'll go with Hurt Me Plenty. Yeah, that sounds good.
So it takes about 20 minutes to fully beat the game on any level, I think.
Yeah, pretty much, yeah.
It depends on how much you kite at the end of each wave.
Wait, is it actually?
It's full screen misspelled.
Fake something.
Oh well.
It was on purpose, it was on purpose.
Did we all test this game and not catch this? That's why we need beta testers.
Blink, you're hired.
Nightbot does not like you.
Oh, I see.
I don't know how to edit things on Nightbot. Oh, there's just one L.
You can't keep me from getting home.
All right, so let's show some of the tips that we've made to kind of help people to be able to beat the game. Tip number one is about conglomerates.
Yeah, so conglomerates are a new monster that we added to the game in the recent update. So basically, if 12 COVID demons combine, so if they stack up on top of each other while you're running around, they all combine into one big monster, which only counts as one monster on the wave counter. So how the game works is that if there's any monsters remaining on the wave, they will keep spawning. So the 12 monsters will turn into one, you'll have additional monsters as well as this strong mega conglomerate. So it is best to try to prevent them from turning into conglomerates. If you see about 12 of them coming together, you need to shoot them as fast as possible.
Right. So what we noticed is when people would play the Game
lawn.
Jam version, mm-hmm. is they just kited it around all the monsters in one middle puddle.
Yes. So we couldn't make it that easy, of course.
We had to give them something a little bit more challenging. And so that's becomes the conglomerate.
Yes.
And I love it.
Definitely.
Alright. So if you notice, while he's playing, there are these little blue bottles that pop up right there. They give him health, they give him ammo, and they give us tip number two.
Yeah, so these are the pickups that you want to be trying to get throughout the game to restore any health or ammo so that you are able to keep fighting the waves of monsters. They always give 25 health throughout the entire game. As the game goes on, it does also give you ammo. So from wave 1 to 4, it will refill your machine gun. So that's your base weapon that you always have. And as you progress in the game and buy items, you can get more weapons. So you can get shotguns and rockets. So from waves 5 to 10, you can also get shotgun ammo from picking up the false bottles. If you are playing in the two easier modes of Hurt Me Plenty and I'm Too Young to Die, it also does give you that rocket ammo in wave 5 to 10. But for the more difficult waves, it only gives the machine gun and the shotgun.
It used to only give the machine gun.
Yes.
That is an improvement. It gives you a little bit more. But this game is not very forgiving on ammo. Mm-hmm. Oh yeah, we'll go over the shop purchases as well. Andrew might just talk through it as you go to the shop.
Yeah, sure.
It really does affect the game, like what order you buy things in.
For sure. Yeah, I've already bought a few of the items. One of them was a ammo bag at the very start, which increases your maximum capacity, which is really important throughout the entire game, just to make sure that you have enough to keep going on. Because if you run out, you know, the enemies, they're going to conglomerate, they're going to pick you off slowly. There's a few other weapon options, a few speed upgrades, including a dash that I already picked. Some health things and damage, which I'm actually going to grab right now because that's really important for the waves coming up.
So you got a double damage just now, which makes everything 2x damage what it normally did. And then later, you can save up your caps and you can get a quad damage, which actually does 3x.
Yeah, 3x.
It's very much like Quake
get
in that it doesn't do 4x.
first big enemy.
These are some of the new monsters that we added in the update. So the one that's shooting the lightning bolt, that is the Shambler. And if you played the Game Jam version, which only had the Cobra Demons, you can see in this wave that we also added new levels of Cobra Demons. So here, these purple ones are the Tainted Demons, are a little bit faster. Then we also added the Shrags that shoot those acid projectiles.
It gets to be a lot, doesn't it? Okay, so Nightmare, you can't get hit once.
Not once. No matter what.
I've already taken 7 hits, so I've won the game 7 times.
I do love that you added stats to the full version. That's fun to see.
Very handy. Just to kind of keep track of how many caps you've collected in case you want to check with other games that you're playing to see how much you would spend by then, see how lucky you've gotten, see if there is a 1-3 drop rate on caps.
Okay, so it's not the same every time.
Yeah, it's not. And that kind of influences how much you're going to spend on different rounds. Because, you know, if you get lucky on the first round, maybe you'll have enough to buy a rocket launcher, but later down the line, you might get less lucky, you might not have enough for double damage. It means you have to really keep track of how much money you're getting in what wave and what you buy in what order.
Nice.
I'm gonna get the shotgun.
Some ammo.
Still got 60 left over, so we can probably grab some.
How many armors are there?
There are exactly 10, each one increasing your health by 10 HP, so you can go up to a maximum of 200. And
nice.
I'll probably grab a couple of those. Or I guess just one.
Rip and tear.
Those caps go fast. Aw, Daisy. So this was like a last minute addition. McCree, like, he was like, I'm done. And I was like, can you make it fun?
Had to be done.
It did. So if anyone doesn't know Doom Lore, Doom has a pet bunny named Daisy. He has had Daisy to his house.
A little more motivation to protect his home from these monsters.
How they get angry when you hit the COVID demon.
Yeah.
And they get that little angry look on them. Adorable. Andrew's too quiet. Andrew, can you turn your mic?
Yeah, I'll do that. Now, how's this?
Hopefully better. Takes a few seconds
ammo.
To come to...
I might just save the money this round to hopefully get quad next round.
Rip and tear.
So he's on wave 7 of 10.
Definitely a little bit different since you're aiming in a 2D space, but in the end, you know, if you're able to quickly snap between the enemies, that's a lot more likely to carry you to victory.
Oh, there you go. Yeah. Oh, bomber right there.
Really close.
As much as we want to show it off, we also want to play his sister. Well, we never did show the jump boots, so whenever he jumps from side to side. Those are the jump boots. That's our tip number 3.
Yeah, so the jump boots, they're a shop item that has a dash ability. So whenever you dash, you gain about 26 frames of damage invulnerability, so it's able to pass by monsters and not get hurt. You just press the space bar and you're able to reuse the ability every 3 seconds.
So 26 sounds like a high number, but it's actually very quick.
Oh yeah,
yeah. Get off.
You have to
really time it.
Be very careful in using it and not getting carried away.
Ooh, what are those?
Those are the ogres.
So the ogres, they have where they shoot the grenades from far away, and then they also have a second attack. Whenever you go up close, they will pull out a chain gun.
Chain gun. It's a melee.
Mm-hmm. They're really good at just causing chaos with all the grenades, so you gotta be careful and watch your step.
This is 8 of 10. There's still 2 more attacks.
Yeah.
And you can't get hit at all in Nightmare.
In Nightmare? Yeah. You have to survive all 10 rounds of that.
Oh, I gotta be a little bit less clumsy or I'm not going to beat this last wave.
So what are your stats now?
Not perfect accuracy.
Hey,
26,
it's not too bad.
26 hits taken. That is... a lot.
That's a lot of restarting.
Let's go ahead and get the HE rounds and chainsaw there.
We also added the chainsaw in this update for the player, so you can start having some melee damage as well.
We should do a tip about that. We haven't yet, but we should. Because that's kind of tricky to use.
It's also hidden behind a lot of the items.
Mm-hmm.
So here we're getting the Infernals for the first time.
And they are even faster?
Yeah. Strags projectiles are even more damage.
Just lightning to the face. I feel like you should be
shouting.
Yeah,
I keep doing that.
I know. And as he moves to the south side of the lawn,
he snuck up on one of his tanks and dodged the blast of the chain.
He just strafed right into that one.
Yeah.
Dive into the middle.
Man,
so
I'm
halfway
really
through flopping. This wave.
What?
It's about halfway through this wave.
Yeah.
Can he do it? Can he control it?
I don't know.
Probably
not. 2 more mobs to go. Look at that Infernal. Really wants.
Oh, my dash was just barely not reset there.
A good example of how to not use a dash.
He's doing pretty good mob control, though.
Absolutely. He still hasn't had any conglomerates. That's pretty good.
I think that's my biggest problem. Now, I can beat it on this level, but I don't make it past wave 4 on the next one.
Yeah.
Wave 10 is going to be hard here.
Alright, so I don't think we've ever streamed or seen a stream of someone at level wave 10.
No, we have not.
World's first.
World's first.
World's first premiere.
Love it.
Not quite enough to buy out the shop. But I think I got the most important items.
Rip and tear.
Here we go. introducing the cyber demon.
I think one of the biggest things everyone wanted from the game jam release is a big bad.
Yeah, so we heard the request from what head, we added the final boss to the end of the game. So on wave 10, you do face the cyber demon as well as
everything
else in the game.
Why not?
The cyber demon shoots these homing missiles whenever you are far away. And then it has a second attack where it shoots missiles that do not follow your player when you're about mid-range. And it also has a melee attack as well if you are right.
Can you shoot those?
Yes, you can shoot the homing missiles. Only the homing missiles.
I don't know if we're gonna see a nightmare one.
And with the dodge and the careful control of the homing missiles and monsters, it is possible. With how sloppy I've been, it doesn't look possible, that's for sure. But you can even use the homing missiles to kill the other demons.
You can use the chainsaw.
Oh yeah, the chainsaw.
Yeah.
Always forget.
Okay.
Wipe that away.
That was it. It's so fast.
It is,
but you have to get right
up
next to them. You have to get right in there.
Mm-hmm. It's a one-time use for wave.
Oh, okay.
And it does 100 damage.
Wow.
Which will take out most monsters. I think everything except the cyber.
Okay. And can you hit more than one monster? It looked like you killed several of them.
So.
Yeah, it hits anything that that is over.
Ooh.
There we
cyber
go.
Demon's
dead. Right on time.
So with that, he took out the final boss and all the remaining monsters.
He doesn't really need.
I don't
the
know
cat.
Why I'm collecting the cats.
I know.
Yeah, it's
like
that's the end your round. I think everyone does this. It's just so satisfying.
It's ingrained in everyone's soul. They have to pick up any loot that drops.
Home sweet home.
And there we go.
Yeah.
And the vulture violent. No. Hurt me plenty.
Hurt me plenty.
There we go. First try.
Yay!
Woo!
So that is the end of the game, which we've added, you know, new difficulties, new waves, new monsters. If you've played the Game Jam version, you notice that this end screen is different from the first easy version of the game. And you have a unique one for each one going forward, which is how whenever you're doing this contest for the Ultra Violence and the Nightmare mode, you'd be taking a screenshot of that last scene that we just saw.
Which wouldn't be that scene to win a prize.
Right.
Correct. It had to be Ultra Violence or Nightmare for the contest.
Great. Okay.
Right.
So tell us a little bit about the difference in difficulty.
Well, it's somewhat of a spike, but the difficulty changes don't occur everywhere. The main difference that one could notice is in the damage that each monster does. So with the increasing of the difficulties, different monsters are going to do more damage. So namely, the Kova Demon, which is kind of the main factor that you're going to be noticing as you're progressing from one difficulty to the other. In, I think, easy mode, they do, which is, I'm too young to die, they do about 10 damage, which is pretty negligible. That's about, you know, 10% of your health. So you can take 10 hits from them and still live. But that can add up. On Hurt Me Plenty, they do, I believe, around 20, so you can take about 5 hits without dying. On Ultra Violence, that's when it really spikes up in difficulty, because that's when you can only take 2 hits without dying, without getting further upgrades. A Nightmare, of course, as we talked about, it's just 1 hit, 1 kill, and Endless, it has the same difficulty as Hurt Me Plenty, but the waves just don't stop.
Wow, so it just keeps going for however much stamina you have or until you die.
Yeah.
Basically compare with other players and brag about how far you can get.
Yeah, sure, yeah.
in the, you've added with the stats and the timer, you can see like at 40 minutes I got this far into the game, or
Even has a lot of replayability, and just in the easier difficulties you can just keep playing and see how fast you can beat it, because that can be a whole game in of itself, besides just beating them.
Right.
Because if you're racing, that also means how much time are you going to take at the end of the wave, because you have to pick up all those caps. You have to get those pickups during the wave's progression. You have to take them out quickly. You have to navigate the shop fast. And then you have to consider, you know, how much you want to buy at what time. That can really add up to a lot of strategy if you're trying to beat the game fast.
By the way, thanks for Chris Sweat for tipping us $25. That was very sweet of you.
Thank you.
Thanks.
So, Andrew, do you want to try this on Nightmare, or do you just want to go Ultra Rare?
Nightmare.
It's up to you.
We can go into Nightmare for a bit, see how it goes, and if things aren't going well, just hop back in Ultraviolence.
Okay.
Get off my lawn.
Yeah, I'll give it a shot.
We can at least show it off a little bit. You know, wave one, two, maybe
sure,
four.
Yeah.
See how far you can get without getting
with
hit.
With the increase of the difficulties as well, there is less ammo coming from the boss pickup, so you're going to have to be really accurate and conserve if you don't want to be spending all your money.
Right.
Which something we've actually seen from some streamers is just waiting with the last enemy alive to pick up the last pickups just to get that extra ammo.
Yeah. It's a good strategy. It does take a lot of time, so if you're wanting to beat it in a certain time period, this isn't the strategy. Right.
Yeah, for sure.
But if you're just going for completion, it doesn't matter.
Sure.
Yeah, you could have waited for two more spawns then.
That's alright. Whenever one of them is picked up, actually no, I think this is constant. Just if you see one that has spawned, it's already started another timer for the other item to spawn.
Okay.
So you can go ahead and kill them after you see one spawn, because the other one will already be queued up. But I think they spawn every 8 seconds or so.
So what are you going to go for buying here, Nightmare Mode, where there's no forgiving?
So I'm going to get Life Regen. I think that's going to be the best option. No. Really, on Nightmare, I think one of the most important things is just ammo. So I'll grab the ammo bag and just restock as much as possible. And with the ammo bag especially, if you're doing the strategy where you're just going to kind of wait with the last enemy on the board to get those refills, it's definitely worth it, because you will be gaining a lot more ammo than you would be otherwise. Always gotta watch your back.
I see a lot of people get stuck in the upper corner.
Speaking of which,
gotta concentrate. Alright, we're good. Yeah, it's really important to prioritize which COVID demon you're targeting, because if you don't kill the ones that are blocking your path, then you're not gonna last very long.
Yeah, that's a good tip. Just clear your path as you go. Don't just go for the bulk of them. Your path is a little bit more important.
I'm not going to draw this on too long. I just want to get a couple.
Yeah, you've only got 3 clips there. Not even full.
Yeah. I've seen some people taking advantage of the injury state on the COVID evens as well, while in this waiting period, because you can just bring them to their weakest point one clip at a time, and once you're there,
How many bullets are in a clip?
There are exactly 20 bullets in a machine gun clip. There's 2 in a shotgun, and you do have to click to reload. So once you shoot twice with the shotgun, it is very important to click again to go ahead and get the reload started.
That's another good tip. Let's start writing these down so I can put them up on our Twitter and Facebook and Discord channel.
Check for any
we want people to succeed, so we
yeah,
give them
sure.
tips.
Alright, so past this point, other than ammo, getting some speed is going to be really important.
So you just bought a case of Nuka-Cola for some speed?
Right now, I'm deciding between the jump boots for the dash and the rocket launcher.
As a note, just real quick while we're in the screen, this music that was for the vending machine was written by Xander Pyle, which is the third of the Pyle children.
Yeah, he did help with composing the music, so that was the one original song that we had in Quarantine Arena. So it was really nice he was able to add that in.
Yeah, it was a late dinner for QuakeCon. It was like 10 p.m. Saturday night. This thing is due at 9 a.m. the next morning. And they're like, yeah, we don't have any music for the vending. I don't know what we're going to do. And Xander's like, can I make music? He sat down and he just did it within 5 minutes.
Yeah, it was really impressive for the pace. This wave is where things get a bit more dicey. Forgetting I don't have the dash.
Not yet. Gotta make it one more.
Ooh.
That was even closer.
Yeah.
Well, you're almost wave 4 on Nightmare.
Yeah. I think if you hit yourself with splash damage on the rocket launcher on this mode too, that's also an instant death.
Oh.
So try not to use your rocket launcher up
too
close.
Yeah. I think it's neat it has splash damage. That's another good tip.
Alright, we're looking pretty good so far. Oh, here's a tough choice. So, I got a little bit lucky on caps. Now I have just enough to grab double damage.
Yeah, that'd be hard to pass up.
Yeah, it is. Are we going
into
4 or
wave 5? So this is where strategy comes in. I mean, this is... You're going into 4.
Alright, I think I'll get the double damage then.
Yeah, so not shamblers yet. Shamblers at 5?
Yeah, exactly. Because if we have shamblers, I definitely want the dash. That way I don't get eaten alive by that lightning. So we're going to go with that and hopefully have enough to buy the jump boots and some more ammo next time.
You can't keep me from getting home.
Yeah, that lightning can certainly catch you off guard.
Yeah, for sure.
We watched this one stream and he... hadn't gotten to wave 5 before. This is first time. He spawns outside the door and got electrocuted. Never even saw what it was. That was so sad.
Right now I'm standing a bit too still.
Oh, this is bad. This
I'm
is bad.
Get a corner. There we go.
Yeah.
Ooh. Ooh. Gotta really watch where you're going.
Oh man, that was intense.
Didn't think we'd make it this far.
You scared me. So... I for sure thought you were just gonna run right into him after fighting that whole wave. I was like, really on stream?
Alright, I think we're good there. It's fine where that last spawn is.
There it is. Alright, so now some jumpy.
Yep. Now, I have a little bit left over. I think we might save most
shotgun?
Of it. Probably pick up the shotgun, yeah. Because it's wave 5 now, so that's when... the balls start filling up the shotgun shells. So it's really good to have it on this wave just to make sure that you're restocking on even more ammo.
How far have you gotten in this level?
On Nightmare, I think I've gotten to wave 6 or 7.
Ugh.
5 is where most of those runs die.
Right. So this may be the last wave for us.
Rip and tear.
The first priority I want to do is find the Shambler and take him out. So I just gotta pour all of my ammo in.
Good job.
He's done with, but the amount of monsters has really racked up this round. We can deal with the tainted ones in a way faster. And the scrags are equally a threat, since on this difficulty, their acid is way faster.
Oh, no.
Oh, nice use of the rocket there. Good weapon switch.
I think that's a big part of it too, is knowing when to use your weapons.
And a lot of the time, you just have to prioritize where you're looking over what you're shooting. Because if you're not looking where you're going to run into an enemy.
You did that really well. I mean, that was...
Yeah, that was pretty,
You're making this look easy.
Solid run.
I
feel much better about our contest now.
Yeah, so it's just a Tom Win nightmare.
It just takes a lot of practice, which, with development, I had an unfair amount of.
There's a reason
although,
why
of course,
you're... Oh, sorry, what'd you say, Cameron?
Down. Of course we can't play down that Andrew's a god game.
Oh, yeah.
It certainly helps. Oh my gosh, why?
just to scare you a little bit.
What is wrong with you?
So that does show off the invulnerability frames.
No.
However... Oh my god. What a show off. Yeah, Andrew!
That's good, you're gonna make a mistake.
Alright, just a couple more spots.
You're a nightmare, dude!
Don't do it.
Keeping the entertainment alive.
I'm basically full on machine guns, but I want the shotgun shell. There we go.
Throwing for content.
Dash through demons like it's nothing, okay.
Alright. We have nowhere near enough for quad. But... Might as well grab some rockets, and probably gonna save the rest. The HE rounds are pretty good, because they can save some ammo and take out some extra demons, especially with the rocket. But I think quad's more worth it, so I'm actually gonna hold off on purchasing this wave.
Get off my lawn.
Alright, here's hoping we get
so
to
same
spend
deal.
Those.
Yeah, two shamblers.
Do they always spawn first?
They do not. Ah!
Oh!
Of course, that's how it would go down, just a single strat.
Yeah.
But that's all it takes, just one enemy.
Doesn't matter how strong.
Yeah, if you're one half a second late to hitting that space bar for the dash, then it's all over. But
you
we got 11 minutes in, 6 waves, that's pretty good for Nightmare.
It is,
yeah,
for your first shot.
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah. Alright, what do you think? We're going to Ultraviolence or back into Nightmare again?
That's up to you. I think the next thing we'll go over is, now that you are a company, what are you going to do?
Well, we're definitely going to be spending more time in developing more titles. We are already looking at making the next game, and we want to make one that is our own and something original. This was a fun parody project that we did for the game jam. It was nice to finish it out a bit more by adding more content and seeing what we can do. But we would like to make something that is purely Nocturnal Studios, so we can, you know, be proud of for our company. We don't have a release date yet for any teasers, but we are going to be, putting more work on that. So if any of you want to follow along with any of our social media, joining our Discord, you will be seeing updates on the new unreleased game in the upcoming months.
And always our website, nocturnalstudios.net, which has a link to all of our Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, Discord, all of that.
Yeah, I'm pretty excited for where our team is going to be going in the next 20 months.
And you got a lot of people watching.
Yeah.
You can't keep.
You gotta do something.
Definitely gotta make it happen. So
that energy off of a release, it feels good, doesn't it?
Oh yeah.
Yeah,
I think just being able to get this done and watching how many people tuned in, downloaded the game, tried it out, just kind of gave us that boost that we needed to want to keep going and make more.
Mm-hmm.
And I think we're all really excited about making more games, more content for everybody to play and have fun with, so it's a fun journey for us.
For sure.
Great.
Couldn't have said it better myself.
All right, so we are going to go ahead and we've got two more points, I think, to wrap up, but it makes us leave the game. So thank you, Andrew. That was a great showing for Nightmare and just the game in general. We appreciate it. And I think it's this one. That one didn't do it. It didn't do it. So.
Yeah, so speaking of creating new titles and wanting to make more games and keep growing the studio, we are looking at expanding our team if anyone is interested in working on small indie games. Then feel free to reach out to me. Again, my name is Crystalline. You can contact me at my email that's listed on there, or if you're in a Discord, you can find me. I go by Starbuck, and just send me a message if that's something that you are interested in doing. We are particularly looking for more coders and artists. So if you would like to work with us, you can send some of your example work and just talk about what we're looking for.
And just keep in mind, it's an indie company where everyone has income from other sources.
Oh, yes. Everyone here volunteers. So this is more of in our free time, we like making games.
Project out of passion.
But hopefully it'll turn into more. That is the goal.
If we are successful, then maybe it'll turn into something else. But
it's
for
a good
now,
point to start and maybe get some more experience under your belt. And working with a team is very important.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah, I think everyone here, we're doing this just, we're learning a lot ourselves just by working together as a team. I think the Game Jam did a lot of that for us, of having that first experience of working with others and putting your skills together to see how far you can go, and that helped us a lot on what we are wanting to do going forward. So if we had anyone else to be for doing this,
well,
same
I can't wait
work.
Because I want, as a marketing director, I want more stuff to put out there.
More stuff to put out there. Yeah. But perhaps someday.
Soon.
Someday soon, yes.
So that does lead us to our final point, is we have another contest. So we recently added Quarantine Arena to be able to be a category in Twitch, so that whenever you stream, you can choose your category, you can put Quarantine Arena, and then that will notify anyone on Twitch that looks for a Quarantine Arena stream. It'll put you on that list. So we're going to be watching that, and we want to see people stream.
Yeah, so definitely if you are streaming in your games, use that tag, and we will pop in and watch. It's super fun for us.
It is really entertaining to see people play. Because everyone has a different strategy in how they go about it.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, it's great to see how people approach Quarantine Arena and what they buy in the shop.
Right. So you can also tell us in Discord that you're streaming. But if you are streaming and we show up and you win the random dice toss, you'll get a t-shirt.
Absolutely.
And this is with the tainted COVID demon. Mm-hmm. It's purple for Twitch. That's not why it was purple, but it worked out.
It does go well together with Twitch's color scheme.
And there will be 5 of these winners.
Yes. Yeah, 5 streamers have a random chance of winning the t-shirt if they are using the Quarantine Arena tag on Twitch.
I think this is one of my favorite iterations of the COVID Demon t-shirt, too.
Looks nice.
So there's 3 types of t-shirts to win.
Mm-hmm.
And all of them are for free. Mm-hmm. And you just have to play the game, basically.
Just play games. Win t-shirts. Or balls prizes.
That's amazing.
Yeah.
So, I guess that's what we have.
Yeah. Yeah, I think that's all we have for today.
we'll leave you with the trailer of Quarantine Arena. And thanks for tuning in. We'll have more dev streams. If we can get more people actively playing, maybe we'll stream us watching people play and rolling the dice and giving out some t-shirts, because that'd be really cool.
That'd be fun.
All right. See you next time.
Thanks.
See ya.
Get off my lawn.